the board. So that's the answer. Second question you asked me about recently, spectacular change has been made in women's history. It's like a glass of water. If you feel that the glass of water is half, then it is half changes we have made. If we feel that yes, at least glass of water is half filled, so it is very subjective and objective. I feel that we have made a lot of changes and we have made in Congress government. Why I am more political than BJP and Congress? Later on we have a separate debate. Why women, there is no spectacular change has been made in past 4 years. There are several examples I can quote. But yes, we have women Prime Minister, we had President of India Prime Minister, we had Speaker of Prime Minister, we have several ministers, this is Prime Ministers, and it is Rajiv Ji who brought Panchayat Raj Bill, and he got 33%, this is 74th Amendment. Because of 74th Amendment, I am in front of you as a woman councillor, and of course without reservation I take him up here, thank God. So that was a different political situation. In this scenario, I perhaps would have not entered politics. Of course, that is a different scenario. I feel that to be more like a grassroots politics, help the people and all that. Anyway, so we have made a spectacular change. I don't think there is any single field where woman is not. Okay, I can restrict my point to sexism. I don't agree to Hillary Clinton's because I have not read her book. But Hillary Clinton comes from the Western world. Her situation is different. Her voter, her voters were women who did not vote for her. It's a different kind of a, let's not compare. But I always women, women feel very happy to vote for woman. This is my observation.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. You know, I just want to add a point here that, you know, the reason why I mentioned.
But I figured out was for US, making a first woman president wasn't really the criteria. The criteria was on various parameters. And they somehow felt that Hillary didn't do justice to get that particular title. Unfortunately, we all sitting back home felt that she deserved to be the first woman president of the United States and any day a better president than Donald Trump. However, in the minds of the people in the US, it was otherwise. That the gender wasn't really important. Second, when you ask me this question, I'm too much, very honestly. When I look at women empowerment as an issue, the biggest challenge that women face, they drop out of education by the age of 18 because their parents ask them to get married. There's immense pressure for them to get married. And I speak from experience because I was 19 when I got engaged and married at 21. And that was an arranged match. So, statistics suggest that women, if they choose to marry later, they tend to have more informed children because their education is not hampered. Their education, hopefully, I mean, if this something like this is meant in as a more empowerment as a tool, then they end up studying and they end up choosing correctly and end up having delaying the process of making babies once they're mentally prepared for it. I was a mother at 24. I definitely wasn't prepared because I didn't even know what life is about. So in a way, I feel that there could be a discussion on that, honest and fair discussion. But if it is with the mindset of believing that women can be influenced, etc., obviously the mindset that the Bharatiya Janata Party has is known to all. Is something extremely, I would say, a regressive point of view. So I since I haven't read the bill, I do not know what the members' bill has. Every statistic suggests that at least in India, women should marry a little later so that they know what they're getting into, they understand the pros and cons. And like every rickshaw in Mumbai tells you, Mulgi Shikhi Pragati Jhali. When you teach a girl, when you teach a woman, you educate an entire family. That is when you understand your own body, you understand your own responsibilities, you understand what you can contribute to the society, is when you're mentally prepared to take on choosing marriage, choosing your partner, choosing to have become a mother, choosing your own career. That is what I believe.
Okay. You know what I'm going to do is I have a lot of questions to ask. Ladies and gentlemen, please keep your questions ready. We're going to come to you as well. But I would just request the panelists to be brief in that answer, because I would like to ask you a lot of stuff and get your quick response. I'm going to come to you, Kiranjit, first. I'm just going to give it to you. You know, and you don't have to get political at all. The Time magazine's Person of the Year is a very prestigious announcement. This year, and you know, since you are from the medical fraternity, you probably know better. This year, the Me Too movement, the women behind the Me Too movement, the hashtag Me Too movement, when everybody came out and talked about the kind of sexual harassment they experienced in different times, they were collectively nominated as a Person of the Year. Do you think at this point, and as a doctor as well, that the issue of sexual harassment is something that is still being conceived in the cupboards because of the shame it brings up in society? Or is it because people still believe that there is not enough justice being done? And I want your answer in the Indian context, and if you have a personal experience of people who have come to you with those experiences, would you like to narrate something?
Certainly. In fact, it is definitely there. And always hidden because of the shame. You know, in the 35 years of my practice, I have seen so many instances of sexual abuse. Usually it's a young girl in a wedding party, some member of the family, and invariably it's some trusted uncle or family member who has molested the girl. And this is as high, we had done a survey by the way, and it's as high as 70% of girls in their adolescence have had some sort of molestation. Maybe an exposure, maybe fondling, maybe insinuation, and some of them actually rape. And in my practice, I see it all the time. I see so much of incest. I see so much of, you know, brother, sister, father, children over the years. And it's all hidden because nobody wants to come out because the police and the whole society is so insensitive. For years together in Kama Hospital, I used to examine the rape victims. And let me tell you, these poor rape victims are put through hell. Many of them either commit suicide because it is so insensitive for them in the police station, their morals are questioned, their way of dressing is questioned, and really, and I'm sure all of us over the years we have seen in the press and also Bianca Ji have spoken, I know we were on Face channel together, I think, over one of those. And it was all about child molestation. So we see it all the time. This Me Too happens not only in every phase, in colleges, schools, in the workforce, and especially women. I always feel I know a little protective when they are doctors or dentists, they can stand for themselves. But in the corporate world, you can't go ahead in your profession unless you count out to your bosses. And this happens all the time. I have many people, many women who are from the film's model fraternity, and all of them say that the casting couch is definitely there. And I have had patients whom I can trace their herpes zoster infection or herpes simplex infection from so many people. So you know, it's very much there. So it's rampant, it is completely covered, and if you have a Me Too movement in India, I think every man is going to be shocked.
Now I think let me tell you, that's a very honest assessment coming from somebody who's probably seen it all and you know kind of seen people who get affected by it. And I think therefore maybe Nebulaji, you might come in here and you know I think these are serious issues that we need to address. You know, we are talking here about empowerment to women. And I think the basic elementary hygiene that we need to empower women is safety and security. And that itself is missing. And therefore my question to you, since you have also been a mayor of Mumbai earlier and you understand the challenge of women across the board, do you feel that if this government were not to pass the bill on women's reservation, it would be doing a great disservice to, I think, 50% of India's population? And to that extent, if they don't pass it, what should be done to make sure that they do pass it?
I'll be very short in answering this, but there will be a little information which audience request to be given for earlier, that taking consent is not regarding Shetty's matter. He has put up this one. Priyanka said that yes, 21 years is the age, is the ideal age, but law doesn't say so. The law says that a woman, once she becomes 18, she's fit to marry. So legal position for a boy is 21 years and legal position for a girl is 18 years. Only child parents are not allowed, which are below 16 years. And rural and urban situations also are taken into consideration. Yes, physically, socially, economically, it is ideal to have a marriageable. But what Gopal said, he was a counselor with me, I know his nature. So, and he is BJP man, so definitely he will enter into consenting, parenting, and all that. Again, patriarchal mindset that consent, Sanskriti. So, they want to catch votes of the parents. So, they go, हमारे बारे में उनको कितना पढ़ा है कि माँ बाप के परमिशन के बिना नहीं होना चाहिए ये kind of वो उनका माइंडसेट है. So, we should not think much over it. People will not accept it. Secondly, what madam also said, sexual harassment bill, the Sexual Harassment Act at workplace, prevention, repression and protection has been passed in 2013 with the aims and objective that a woman has a dignity status, she needs to be protected at the workplace. It's a responsibility of every employer to see that no hostile or right atmosphere is given to her, one minute only. And therefore, if anybody has any problems, please come to us. We give lot of lectures on that. How to have redressal mechanism over it and what is sexual harassment, how it. But may I tell all of you that sexual harassment at workplace is not only for any white collar intellectual and elite corporate woman. They are only 3% of the society. 93% of the society people are from unorganized sector, and sexual harassment will actually protect them. तो अगर आपके पास कोई काम वाली भी बाई है अनऑर्गेनाइज सेक्टर है प्लीज कम टू अस वी विल एंश्योर दैट रिड्रेसल मैकेनिज्म इज इन द प्लेस एंड विल हेल्प यू टू सी दैट आवर इंडस्ट्रीज इज रिड्रेस नाउ कमिंग बैक टू योर पॉइंट दैट इज अबाउट द 33% रिजर्वेशन इन पार्लियामेंट यू आर अवेयर कि बीजेपी एंड कांग्रेस रिपीटेडली प्लेज फॉर सपोर्ट टू वीमेन रिजर्वेशन विल रिसेंट ऑल्सो हमारी जो चलो खिचड़ी सरकार थी सॉरी टू से कांग्रेस की वी हैड अ फ्रैक्चर्ड मैंडेट बट एवरी बड़ी इन नेशन नो दैट कांग्रेस इज वीमेंस रिजर्वेशन वी हैव अ हिस्ट्री टू दैट वी हैव प्रूवन हिस्ट्री दैट वी स्टैंड फॉर वीमेंस रिजर्वेशन अनफॉर्चुनेटली दादू देन मुलायम सॉरी एंड शरद बट नाउ
माय क्वेश्चन टू यू या दिस इज व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू दिस डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन
या
नाउ द गवर्नमेंट डज नॉट पास द बिल What do you think women should do?
First of all, this question itself can be challenged. Why will they not pass? Why should they not? Now they have 3-4 majority. So we must take a nationwide anger against the BJP. कि अभी आपके पास तीन चतुर्थ बहुमत है, means आपको करना ही नहीं है वो bill. तो we should all of us, I will take Priyanka and everybody to raise freedom and everything. के government की कोई ख्वाहिश नहीं है महिलाओं को जब मोदी जी आए थे तीन बार तो बोलते हमको महिलाओं ने वोट दिया एवरी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी एजेंडा में लिखते हैं मैनिफेस्टो के का मूवमेंट की कम टू पावर हम लोग 33% रिजर्वेशन वी एक्टिवेट कर 50% व्हाई 33% राज्य के लिए 50% दिया है इस पर तो व्हाई 33% वी वन मिनट दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग एंड आगे ना एक ही बार मुझे पेशेंट में मैं छोड़ूंगी नहीं किसी को भी भले निर्मला सामंत को कुछ नहीं मिले चलेगा लेट प्रियंका बिकम लेट शी बिकम लेट एवरी ये क्या है ना मेरे को भी मैं रिजर्वेशन मिल चाहिए मेरे को रिजर्व लेकिन मेरी ये छोड़ के गद्दी छोड़ के नहीं ये जो है ना दैट इज एक्चुअली प्रिवेटिव पावर इज सच अ थिंग कि मुझे चाहिए लेकिन मेरा छोड़ के अगर मिलेंगे तो नोबडी शुड गो अहेड ऑफ मी ये सब नहीं जाएगा तब तक नहीं होगा वी शुड रेज बिकॉज सोनिया जी हैज रिटन
Gauri Lankesh, we all know, got brutally murdered, right? And we all know British, and the Prime Minister still continues to follow them. That I think is a worry. I mean, you can't ignore that as a serious question. Now, Priyanka Chakravarti, she's a very dear friend of mine as well, has been subjected to some terrible abuse on social media and besides on live television. Live television. Question to you, Priyanka. We are talking empowerment here. You're a woman, you're a mother of children, you are fighting your guts out in politics day in and night out. By the way, over the last couple of days, she's been to Bihar, three different parts of Bihar in one day. She's been in Delhi protesting and here she is after doing an event in the morning. Now, do you, Priyanka, based on your experience, and you have caught it from the right wing trolls, do you believe women in this country are being intimidated and harassed and being, shall we say, given a fear that if you express yourself very openly, we will come after you, abuse you and your family, so that you're frightened into submission? And how do you fight it?
Absolutely. It's extremely targeted. And I must tell you all this very openly and frankly, when you choose politics as a profession, as a woman, you'll have to be mentally prepared for the negatives that come along with it. Of course, there are many positives, because today I believe I'm born into the right gender in the times we live in today. Because I know 33% reservation is going to be a reality. I also am very positive that women are going to change how politics in the future will work in the nation. I'm extremely confident about that. So having said that, there is also a challenge. I know many colleagues of mine who are joining the Youth Congress, women colleagues, who gave up very soon, who said that, you know, it is really stressful to manage the challenges at home. Challenges are the responsibilities that come from home as well as the politics that come. That within a political party, there's politics internally too. Forget fighting externally, also fighting internally, which doesn't would definitely agree with. Of course, now I'll just give you an example of what happened. Since Sanjay Jha is from Bihar, he wouldn't like to believe that Jharkhand is a different state anymore. So Ranchi is in Jharkhand now. So,
ex-Bihar.
A part of Bihar. So, I went and met the student protesters at Delhi yesterday, when they were protesting against the entire corruption behind the SSC exams that are taking place. And the girls came there and told me, they've been protesting for 12 days. They came to me and they told me that they have been denied the use of Delhi's toilet, which is a common facility, on the road of Delhi. They have shut those toilets down. So they organized a mobile toilet for girls to use. They threatened the driver of that mobile toilet to leave immediately. So these girls, despite all the stress that they feel and the stress that they are living through, they're sitting there day in, day out, protesting for what they believe is their right. And me as a woman, who is supposed to be representing that, if I choose to run away from all the trolling that comes from the Bharatiya Janata Party, then I'll be doing a huge disservice to womankind. This is what I totally believe. And that is what keeps me going. I have been threatened on television. I have been called all kinds of names. And this is coming not from just any random human being. It's coming from an office bearer of the Bharatiya Janata Party, the national spokesperson of the Bharatiya Janata Party. And I kept tagging the Prime Minister, I kept tagging Mr. Amit Shah. Nothing is done about it. I'm told every day, day in, day out, but I sincerely believe that if we don't speak up, if we don't continue speaking and getting our voices heard, we are not going to be creating a space that women truly deserve.
Thank you very much, and a big hand to you. And let me tell you something. I mean, there is Chakrika Ghosh, there is Swati Chaturvedi, Arundhati Roy. There are people who have threatened them with dire consequences, and you know, nothing is being really done to even arrest the people, although there is evidence of the fact that there have these hate messages.
I don't know, it was such a challenge for me. I sent a police complaint with regards to this national spokesperson. Till now, the Mumbai police hasn't filed an FIR.
There you are.
So this is where we stand today. This is the aggression that we see coming from the office.
Absolutely. Kiran, let me come to you here on a character artist who performed in a song and became a big national controversy. Everybody's seen that song of Priya Prakash Kharia, right?
Yeah.
And an innocuous song in a cinema that she acted in becomes such an explosive subject. I mean, you know, once again, it targets, I think, women from expressing themselves. I mean, what's your reaction to that, Kelly?
Absolutely. I think we are not secular anymore. That's all the take that I got from that. Because right. I think they were protesting against the Prophet Muhammad's life being sung in the song, and the girl shouldn't be winking at that time. How aggressive are we?
Yeah.
I mean, it's really ridiculous. And you know, it was a sensation. Of course, she's become very popular, but she's facing so much of ire for all the wrong reasons.
Yes.
You know, I don't think, you know, when growing up, we were much more secular than we are.
No, absolutely. And let me tell you this, you know, ladies and gentlemen, you always find that if you, Priyanka will probably back me on this, discussions at prime time or anywhere else are talking about GDP, FDI, GST, but how many of you know that India in the gender disparity index has gone down in Mr. Modi's government from 87 down to 108? Which means in India, the bias of the discrimination being practiced against women has only risen over the last 4 years. I'm not very surprised. And you're very vocal, I can see that. And you know I have to be a slight, I have to behave like that fellow from the Nation wants to know. but it's all right. I'm willing to play all
the time. Quite well.
This is a hard question, right? This is a hard question. Do you feel, because a lot of people are beginning to say, I heard a very senior CEO, a woman CEO of a bank make it in a panel in which I was part of. Do you believe women are failing women as well? Do you think not enough women are standing up to fight for the women's cause? And please give me an answer to that question and not the two questions I asked you.
Yeah. I have not seen due to certain reasons, I have been a little bit away from Twitter, social media and all that. But definitely after joining this forum, the first thing I start is following the social media and all that. It has to go forward, and I would like to support all of you. I would like to support Priyanka and Vishnu, because they also contribute to that. Your basic spirit of the question is that are women our greatest enemies, right?
Are women?
Are their own enemies?
I'm not saying that. That's not the point. Are women not doing enough for women themselves? I'll give you an example.
Yeah.
Let me give you an example. There are instances in a very sophisticated urban South Mumbai where I live there, where there are many women who themselves feed their households. Simple girls who come to work at homes humiliate them, physically trash them, or not pay them enough. I mean, don't you think it starts, charity begins at home? Do you think somewhere that's a failure?
Yes, definitely. What I feel that compassion is extremely important, supporting a girl child, and it is more expected from woman to woman.
Right.
If these kinds of instances come, it is really a shame that that kind of a treatment should not be given to a woman. But if you give me these are the examples, we should jointly condemn. But these must stand with a person who is agreed, with a person who has been dealt in injustice, with a person who is marginalized, with a person who is who requests a certain point. Maybe incidentally, the aggressor is a woman, but by and large, aggressor generally not a woman, and a victim is also generally not, because they are victimized in the certain patriarchal setup. That is where it may appear. But in instances like this, a person who is in a powerful position yet victimizes another woman is a shame, and we strongly protest, we strongly condemn. It's a high time that we all women should gather together and see to it a woman who victimized should be given a strong support.
Absolutely. I don't think anybody will listen to that. Priyanka, coming to you. You know, there is a character in America, by the way, by the name of Harvey Weinstein. Have you heard of Harvey Weinstein?
Yes.
Probably anyone who acted in any Hollywood film under his production house was subjected to some terrible second, getting the kind of transparency we deserve. You know, for example, Kiranji, you mentioned that. You have to make a career in the future, whether it's in modeling or cinema or television. They are subjected to a lot of the same issues that happen in America. In America, it's become a movement. But in India, you never hear about it. You just never hear about it. Rebecca, what should be done to make sure that end of day, misbehave and harassment? What should be done?
So, first, I think the shame around that is who will end up losing. And it is a fact. It's a well encouraged to do what they choose. Women need to be encouraged enough, and they should be made to believe that they're strong enough, and the shame is not there for them to bear. The shame is for the man who chose to behave in a certain way to bear, and not just bear, face charges for it. So this is what needs to change. However, I think we are still a long way away. If you remember, there was a sitra where it happened at some film event, where Kangana not being present was mocked at. So, and I saw so many women who came forward to support the people who were mocking Kangana. But I also saw a whole lot of women and men who shamed them on social media and forced each of that single man to apologize for everything they wrong. So that is, I think, the beginning of a change. And that is what we need to encourage.
But I can tell you, I mean, Priyanka, you've given a very good example. I mean, these were very powerful people from the film fraternity. And you're right, they all had to apologize and they have been very cautious thereafter. You know, Kiranji, that brings me to that point. And, we'll come to you very soon for questions and answers, so please keep your questions ready. If you look at the fact that, today you've got, and you know, all of you know that there is a young kid from Haryana. Do you know her name? Yeah, but you got to do that. She's won the gold medal in 10 meter, I think, air rifle shooting in Mexico, right? She's from Haryana, that is Manu Bhakar. Now let me tell you, whether it's in badminton, you had PV Sindhu, you have had Sania Mirza, you have had Sana Pehwal, you have had again the Fogart sisters. Women are doing remarkably well in sports. But you know, there's something very, I don't know whether you caught that, Indian men cricketers who are doing fantastically well, not taking that away, they have got a pay hike ahead, increased by some 200%. Deserved. Nobody's taking that away. They're playing fantastic cricket, they get the sponsorship money, they've got a 200% increase in their contract pay. Women who entered the finals, Mithila Raj, I mean, they made around, they made the finals of the World Cup and they lost, they got a 10% increase. Do you think this is a very brazen discrimination?
Absolutely. And you know, after all, India is crazy about cricket.
Yeah.
And that is why even when it comes to their advertisements or their salary or everything, it's way, way above every other sport. You know. So it's not only men and women, but it's also the cricket and versus maybe tennis or badminton or anything else. But definitely women are not given their fair share.
They're not given their fair share. Priyanka, put that to you, right? You know, somewhere down the line, the equal pay issue. And I don't know whether you know this again, but Serena Williams,
yes,
when she talked about equal pay, John McEnroe, one of the legendary Grand Slam winners, trashed her saying, you know what, no hope for you. Women don't attract the eyeballs, the crowds don't watch Roger Federer and Rafa Nadal play. The women are beneficiaries of men's sport, men's tennis players. So you can see the bias is pretty deep down within. You know, coming to you very quickly. Do you feel, Priyanka, somewhere down the line, that the battle at the workplace, when we keep talking about the glass ceiling, is still far from being over?
Yeah, absolutely. I agree with you. And I would never be in disagreement as far as equality for women is concerned.
Yeah.
It's just everything that you say, I'm in agreement with on this particular issue. And it happens, I mentioned in this cinema, it happens in the political space too, where winnability of a candidate is usually judged by the gender. And this is a fact. If I was to go approach for a ticket, vis-a-vis any other leader, male leader, strong leader, they would definitely give preference. It, because it has to do a lot with the mindset that is in place. That perhaps Priyanka will not be able to win us the seat, then we just give the male the option. We'll be able to give the time, the effort, the energy, the hours, etc. that is needed. That is when the disparity begins. And that is when the 33% reservation that we keep speaking about is still a mythical agenda that we have in mind. It will become a reality. I have to give you my own personal example. When I went to Karnataka recently, I worked and I was given the charge of recruiting young faces for the organization. I made it mandatory that we will have, if not 50%, 33% women out there who are equally knowledgeable as I am perhaps today, and who need that space which was given to me by my political party, just on the basis of what I was doing so passionately on social media. And Sanjay, you are a witness to that growth story.
Yeah, yeah.
So disparity is there, but we women have the courage and the strength to keep fighting on.
Way to go, way to go. Nirmala ji, you know, I think this is a question for you, tailored for you. You know, Nare, we live in a world of Nare Bazi. Beti bachao, beti padhao. Agree? We all know that. Major Nare Bazi. Now, ye bataiye ki, you know, end of day, what have we done about it? You know, if you look at the message that is coming from the political system, Mohan Bhagwat, who's the head of the RSS, says, a woman is supposed to be in the kitchen. It is a man's job to be the breadwinner. This is a statement coming from the ideological mentors of Mr. Modi's government.
And the marriage being a contract, if a woman can't satisfy her husband and the responsibilities, she's as good as being done. Yeah. And divorce is absolutely okay.
This is the kind of thought process. Nirmala ji, aap ab ye bataiye, and this is not just for, you know, political people. This is a woman's issue. This is a woman's issue. But what I find a hard enough, I mean, you have been a male, obviously. Now, hear my question. My question is, why would a woman supporter of the Bharatiya Janata Party not revolt against it? That's my point. Because ultimately, you are a woman first before you are a member of the RSS of the BJP. What's your
response? I totally agree with you, Sanjay ji. First of all, expecting this from a woman belonging to the BJP and RSS mindset is not sure, we should not be expected.
Yeah.
Because they are also victims of the BJP RSS anti-women. What is BJP ultimately? What is RSS? They are all nothing, sorry, but they are always against women. Their whole hardcore agenda that is fascism, objectifying women, male domination, patriarchy, manuvad. अगर उनके पास manuvad नहीं, patriarchy है, fascism है, women are who? पाव की जुत्ती. अगर women पाव की जुत्ती है, everything. लक्ष्मी को, women is लक्ष्मी, women is सरस्वती, women is दुर्गा देवी. और उनको सिर्फ मंदिर में चढ़ावा चढ़ाओ. But when it comes to giving her equal status, given by Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar in Constitution and given by great leaders, activity में कुछ भी नहीं है. 33% reservation उनके रो रहे हैं. So what I meant to say, what you are right, Mohan Bhagwat, क्या उनसे अपेक्षा करें? वो तो वही बोलेंगे ना. Because this is how they have been taught. This is what they have been trained to. So there is nothing to you know much expect from them. Coming back to जैसे कि अभी cricket खेली, what is cricket? What is this? Ultimately, it's a corporate world. It's a cricket is ultimately media ka bhi bahut negative role hai isme. Sorry to say, a woman jiska bachchi jiska husband karta hai shahid, wo apni teen ki beti ko leke she marches. Media did not give any importance there, but Srinidhi unfortunately died. Unfortunately, Kareena ka bachcha roya, usko headlines sab dete ho. और जो मार्टिर है, जो अपने देश के लिए मरता है, उसको तो आप कुछ भी नहीं पूछते हो. So this is a world which is today is full of consumerism, is full of capitalistic society, is full of, you know, singing the song of the one, money has got so much of importance. So this is going to happen. So what I expect back that Congress, I'm really saying, is the only party which never encouraged these kinds of, of course, people who are there in the Congress party and this is how much they know about the idealism of Congress is a different thing. But by and large, people have understood and recognized the equality, the no gender discrimination, everything. So that's why expecting this from BJP is.
So we are making a mistake by having an expectation at all. Alright, last question to the group and then we will open it up for you guys. Kiranji, let me come to you. You know, there is a lot of debate on the fact that especially in countries and emerging economies where there is a lot of sexual discrimination and gender harassment, that you need good, powerful role models. And I think all three of you, and give them a big hand, a wonderful role model. If I were to ask you that question, you know, we all know there are good role models that are talked about all the time. Any role model for women that you admire personally a lot, who you think is doing visibly a lot to make and fight for the issues of what I call gender parity? Anybody who comes to your mind? Who you admire? Anybody you think very high about?
She
has said. Okay. Yeah, okay, Nirmalaji, anybody who?
I think that every woman is a good role model.
Wonderful.
Yeah. 97% unorganized woman is the best role model.
Your microphone.
We are only 3%. We are not role model because we got good parentage, we got good sanskar at home, we got good parents. Now, we have struggle nahi karna pada. लेकिन 97% women वो struggle करके
Yeah, I think for the knowledge, I think wonderful answer. I don't know how many of you, once again, Jay, I don't know whether you're aware of this, but no, I just recovered you. I think my larger point is that are you aware of this fact that in the Companies Act passed in 2013 by the UPA government, led by the Congress Party, we had mandated that in the boards of companies, you must have a representation of women. That's how change begins. See, if you don't force the change will not happen, right? And these are the things we have done. We don't talk about it, we should. Priyanka, coming to you. Therefore, you know, you are yourself a fantastic role model for women and for that matter, even for men. But hey, what does the great lady, who does the great lady himself admire?
And I can only think of one person who has inspired me since I was a child. And no, I don't say it because I'm a congresswoman. It's only Mrs. Indira Gandhi. And I don't say this because I'm a congresswoman. I say this because every time, you know, I sometimes, I also have my weak moments and I lose hope that anything can change. And such I also have witnessed to my, all my fighting. But every time I think of it, I think I owe her a responsibility to change the dynamics of how women are perceived in this nation. And she will continue being my role model like this forever and ever.
Wonderful. Ladies and gentlemen, you know, we have, I think what we have tried to do, at least, you know, over the last 40 minutes, and I like to be a little punctual on time, otherwise we can get carried away, is to address the challenges that we should not ignore. I think one of the dangerous developments that we find in this government is that they deny anything. You tell them there is a farmer protest happening in Mumbai, they will say it is nothing, it is a political movement. You say, hey, there is a trouble at the border, you say, well, that happened 4 years ago and that's a legacy problem. You say, sir, inflation is rising, but that's because in 5 years ago, Dr. Manmohan Singh did this. 17 years ago, Nehru did this. You see, this is the problem. We live in denial and we should never live in denial. But you know, there is, you know, I was looking at one data, very interesting, that India, by the way, this is fascinating because I was flying on an IndiGo flight a few months ago from Delhi to Mumbai. And I was told in the IndiGo flight that the entire crew was a woman's crew. And that, you felt very proud of that. And the data supports it that India has, on an average, a higher number of airline pilots who are women than the global average. So there are some things which are going right. You could do a lot better. But at this point of time, we want to take a pause and ask you if you have any questions to ask. Anybody has any question for the panel members? Raise your hand and keep your question very brief. Otherwise, I will stop you or interrupt you and tell who you're asking the question to. Anybody has any question here in the audience?
Sanjay, the caption was, watch out Trump, our women are coming for you. Because on the long haul flights to Newark and San Francisco, both the pilots leaving and arriving were all female.
All females, yeah. Alright, and there's a question there.
Coming from a man of my life.
Sure.
Every time I have to give you a long time.
Practice, I've become loud enough, even if they don't, you know, they reduce my volume on television, only my expressions can convey it all. So, in terms of if you ask me about men, my own father, he has been a tremendous support for me at the time when my entire family did not believe I could make it big in politics or reach even the first stage of politics without breaking down. Second has been my husband. I mean, I cannot get out of this room without thanking the man because he looks after the children when I'm gone. I travel just so much and he's always there as a huge support for me when I'm away. And we live in a nuclear family. I choose not to go to Delhi. I live in Bombay because that keeps me sane. So he's a huge support. And the man to my right. Ever since I was someone, a nobody on social media, I have been whining. Every time I feel like whining, I call him. And he's a huge, not W-I-N-I-G, he's not W-I-N-I-G. He's been a huge sense of support. And of course, for giving me the platform, I would say Mr. Rahul Gandhi also, which makes all the right choices with regards to empowering women the way they should be.
Thank you very much.
I can also add on to this what Priyanka said, that today we are facing the 21st century modern era and problems of women. You can just go through what are the problems of women in the modern era and try to change the mindset of the men, because now men have also accepted that if you want to make progress in the nation, there cannot be progress of nation.
I think that so for last 30 years we have one woman who is representing our face, and I consider it the one phase of a woman empowerment. I have a second phase of woman empowerment. We have a reservation in local body, and I think it is 30% or 33% kind of reservation. And but in that case, in the local body, even the female has been elected to the local body, but the administration is run by her husband. Every column. We call him as a sarpanch pati or that kind of thing. And somehow it is a very official, authority, sarpanch pati who is representing her in most of the functions. So how do you see that the current political parties or the system is ready to give tickets to the women, and how we are ready to suppose that the administration will be run by the female representative, not by the sarpanch pati? In future.
Okay,
thank you. Yeah, one thing. Rajivji brought Panchayat Raj Bill to empower a woman to take the decision. The woman should be running the whole administration. But unfortunately, the combination, the requirement of politics is different. So therefore, it is misused. So we should ensure that the real spirit of 33% reservation is not to empower a man. And a man should not run the whole show. And woman is only sitting ideologically. It is not a biological. It is an ideological reservation. So therefore we should ensure that ideologically we should go ahead. And we must sit in the house. When she knows everything, the lady goes to the house. क्या वो देश नहीं चलाएगी? What if देश चलाने कौन सी बड़ी बात है? घर चलाने से भी ठीक है।
आप कुछ पूछना चाहेंगे?
मैं हिंदी में बात करूंगी सर। संजय ज्ञानी आप बोलेंगे कि महिला और वुमेन्स के बारे में ही बोलना है। तो आप बोलेंगे कि बार बार 53% बोल रहे हैं, तो निर्मला जी मैं आपसे सहमत कि अभी मोदी जी समझो हमारे कांग्रेस की तो खिचड़ी सरकार थी, तो उसकी बहुमत ही नहीं थी, तो मोदी जी विकास 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 कर रहा है तो उसकी मेजोरिटी है, तो उसने 50% बिल महिला लोकसभा और विधानसभा में पास करना ही चाहिए। तो मेरा नारी के लिए यही कहानी, आंचल में दूध और आंखों में पानी। कौन बोलता है कि नारी नारी अभी आजाद हो गई है, 50% जो भी कर सकते कर सकती है, मैं अभी भी नहीं मानती हूँ। देश में अगर औरतें ना दाम है ना पाक है, अरे देश में अगर औरतें ना दाम है ना पाक है, दिल पे रखकर हाथ पे, तो देश क्या आजाद है। अरे चुप है लेकिन ये ना समझो हम सदा के हारे, अरे चुप है लेकिन ये ना समझो हम सदा के हारे है, रात के नीचे जल रहे हैं अभी भी अंगारे, अभी भी अंगारे। तो ये किसी में से मुझे एक बार क्वेश्चंस किया गया था फोन में, आपको कौन सी चीज में इंटरेस्ट है, वो चीज में आपको हम आगे बढ़ाएंगे। तो मुझे इंटरेस्ट है क्योंकि मैं म्युनिसिपल काउंसिलर रह चुकी हूँ लास्ट 2017 तक, अभी मैं मुंबई महिला कांग्रेस की वाइस प्रेसिडेंट हूँ। मुझे इंटरेस्ट है कि विधानसभा और लोकसभा के अंदर 50% महिला होना ही चाहिए। तो एएफपीसी को मैं रिक्वेस्ट करती हूँ कि जो आपने मुझे क्वेश्चंस पूछा था उसका मेरा आंसर है कि आप लोग एएफपीसी के जो प्रेसिडेंट है और फुल कमिटी के लेडीज जेंट्स दोनों अंदर है, तो मेरे को जो इंटरेस्ट है उसके अंदर प्रियंका जी और निर्मला जी आप लोग उसके अंदर पहले आगे रहेंगे, मैं आपके पीछे हूँ, और इनके लिए एआईपीसी को हमको हेल्प करना है, जो वो मेरी इंटरेस्टिंग चीज है उसके अंदर आपको करना ही है, हमको हेल्प और ये होना ही चाहिए, और कैसे होना चाहिए वो आप लोग
मैम आगे पीछे नहीं चल रहे साथ साथ चल रहे
personalities who are a light of inspiration for so many. A big thank you for Mrs. Priyanka Chatterjee, AICC Convener, Communication National Spokesperson, for raising our debate. Actually, when we invited her, I had my own doubt because we had not seen her. She was not in Mumbai. She said she is coming late night or early morning. So I told her in the car also that I had doubt whether you come or not. You took the time to come down here. We had gone to invite. We are the first, sorry, second lady mayor of Mumbai.
Am I right?
Yes, I did. I've been to the Indira Hospital also the other day to hear a speech.
I would like to thank you.
Now, the last, I would like to invite all my fellow members who you have contributed to the, make this event a success. I will start inviting Mr. Sapna, sorry, Mr. Sapna. Please come, Benjamin. So we promise, AIC, this is the first. And it will be more event will come. Thank you very much.
Wait.
Please, AFC.
सबसे छोटा मेंबर है
बात करें आज का जो सेमिनार था क्या था और काफी डिस्कशन हुई काफी हर मुद्दे पर लेकर क्या कहना चाहेंगे
मैं बस यही कहना चाहूंगी कि ये AIPC की तरफ से महिला दिवस जो हम बनाते हैं पूरा दुनिया बनाती है देश भी बनाता है 8 मार्च को उसको लेकर था कि कैसे महिलाओं की भागीदारी बढ़ा सकते हैं सरकार चलाने में सरकार बनाने में सरकारों में अहम आवाज बनकर निकलने में और सिर्फ राजनीति में ही नहीं हर तबके में जहाँ पे भी महिलाओं का कम इंटरेस्ट है या महिलाओं की एंट्री किसी ना किसी वजह से कम होती जा रही है
बात करें डेली हर रोज मतलब महिला कांग्रेस के इवेंट हो रहे हैं कल सेनेटर ने अपनी पार्टी गई बैंड्रा में परसों
हाँ जी
तो आज क्या इशू था कुछ डॉक्टरों ने बता रखे थे आपके पैनल में
नहीं हमने हमारा इशू बस ये है इशू नहीं है हमारी जो सोच है
अरे साइलेंस प्लीज
यही है कि हर माध्यम से हमारे इतने सारे फ्रंटल ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस हैं और AIPC अभी ही गठित हुआ है नया एक हमारा फ्रंटल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बन के उभरा है तो जो भी तबके की महिलाएं हैं महिला कांग्रेस के ज़रिए यूथ कांग्रेस के ज़रिए महिला जो विद्यार्थी हैं उनको NSUI के ज़रिए और प्रोफेशनल महिलाएं जो हैं उनको AIPC के ज़रिए उनको अपनी पार्टी से जोड़ें पार्टी के विचार से जोड़ें और जो जो उनको लगता है कि पार्टी में चेंजेस आने चाहिए हम उनकी बात सुने हम वो पार्टी नहीं है जो सिर्फ मन की बात कर छोड़ते हैं हम जन की बात सुनते हैं और इसीलिए ये कार्यक्रम रखा गया है
एक दूसरे की टांगें खींची जाती है कांग्रेस बीजेपी कांग्रेस की AIPC जो है कांग्रेस का ही एक पार्ट है किस तरह की संस्था है
संस्था ये है कि एक हमारे यहाँ पे हम एक गैप देख रहे थे कि प्रोफेशनल्स जो जुड़ना चाहते थे पार्टी से कुछ घंटे वॉलंटियर कर या किसी ना किसी तरीके से वॉलंटियर कर अपनी सुझाव देकर अपने प्रस्ताव रखकर पार्टी में वो शामिल होना चाहते थे पर उनके पास रास्ता नहीं था तो वो रास्ता बनाने का जिम्मेदारी बनाने की जो जिम्मेदारी थी वो पार्टी की बनती है और पार्टी के अध्यक्ष ने ये शुरुआत की ये पहल की कि जो जो प्रोफेशनल्स हैं वो CA हों इंजीनियर हों कोई भी कार्य में काम कर रहे हों या एंटरप्रेन्योर्स हों वो आकर हमसे जुड़ें और पार्टी की विचारधारा को आगे लेकर बढ़ें
आपको कैसा लग रहा है ये कितना प्रोग्रेस की है अभी एक साल के अंदर
एक साल में तो मैं देख रही हूँ काफ़ी उन्नति हुई है AIPC के इतने सारे चैप्टर्स हर तरफ से निकल कर आए हैं उनका कंट्रीब्यूशन भी इलेक्शन की तरफ जो जो इलेक्शन गोइंग स्टेट्स हैं उसमें काफ़ी है काफ़ी रुचि भी दिखा रहे हैं तो ये जो एनर्जी आ रही है AIPC के माध्यम से उसको कैसे हम चैनलाइज करें और पार्टी को और मजबूत बनाएं ये हम कोशिश कर रहे हैं तो पार्टी के जो लीडर्स हैं पार्टी के जो नेता हैं वो इन मंचों के ज़रिए लोगों से जुड़ेंगे
सबसे पहले अपना पूरा परिचय आपका नाम
I'm the president of the All India Professionals Congress for the state of Maharashtra.
सर हम इन बात करना चाहेंगे आपसे, क्या कहना चाहेंगे आज की जो एक सम्मेलन कह सकते हैं, एक सभा कह सकते हैं, क्या कहना चाहेंगे जो आज?
देखिए हमारे तरफ से कोशिश यही है कि समाज में जो भी गंभीर जो भी मुद्दे हैं, जो समस्याएं हैं, उसका हम किस तरीके से उसका समाधान ढूंढे, वही हमारी प्राथमिकता है। आज हमने बहुत सारे बहुत ही जाने माने हमारे महिला वर्ग के लोगों को हमने यहाँ बुलाया, प्रतिनिधि को बुलाया, ताकि वो इस विषय पर बात करें कि आज जिस तरीके से अत्याचार हो रहा है महिलाओं पर, यहाँ पर नारेबाजी बहुत हुई है बेटी बचाओ बेटी पढ़ाओ, लेकिन ज़मीनी स्तर पर क्या कुछ बदलाव हुआ है, क्या परिवर्तन हुए हैं, और इसका जवाब ज़्यादा करके नहीं है। क्योंकि देखिए एक तरीके से प्रजातंत्र को यदि मजबूत करना है तो हमारी महिलाओं को मजबूत करना पड़ेगा, यदि देश में आर्थिक विकास लाना है तो महिलाओं को काम करना पड़ेगा। क्या लेकिन उनको मौके मिलते हैं, क्या उनको वही तनख्वाह मिलता है जो मर्दों को मिलता है, ये बहुत ही अहम प्रश्न है। और हमारा जो एक उद्देश्य है कि जैसे जो भी चीज़ जो भी एक तरीके से मसले हैं, यदि उसका हम सही तरीके से उसका सुलझन नहीं ढूंढेंगे तो भारत का प्रगति रुकेगा। इसीलिए ये एक ऐसा सामाजिक एक तरीके से एक समस्या है जिसका सुलझन ढूंढना अनिवार्य है।
सर हम मुंबई में है, मुंबई आए दिन होता है कि आज कांग्रेस छोड़ के बीजेपी में गया, बीजेपी छोड़ के शिवसेना में आया, तो कितना मुश्किल था आपके लिए यहाँ पे मतलब एज ए हेड ज्वाइन करना?
देखिए हम लोग तो विचारधारा से कांग्रेस पार्टी के साथ मैं समझता हूँ कि जब कॉलेज में थे उसी समय से हम एक तरीके से कांग्रेस पार्टी का जो इतिहास यदि आप देखेंगे तो वो गांधीवादी है, सहनशीलता, धर्मनिरपेक्षता, सबको एक साथ लेकर आगे बढ़ना, कोई धर्म या जात की राजनीति कभी नहीं आने देना। तो देखिए आज जो हमारे सामने भारत में यदि एक तरीके से एक नकारात्मक यदि माहौल हुआ है, सांप्रदायिक माहौल हुआ है, जहाँ पर जात को लेके या धर्म को लेके या मजहब को लेके सियासत होता है, वो इस बात का प्रतीक है कि हम कमज़ोर हो रहे हैं। बयानबाजी में बहुत आगे हैं लेकिन ज़मीनी स्तर पर हम बहुत कमज़ोर हो रहे हैं।
कितनी प्रोग्रेस की एक साल के अंदर या क्या जरूरत पड़ गई थी AIPC की?
देखिए AIPC का जो मैं समझता हूँ गठन लंबे दौर के लिए, ये सिर्फ चुनाव के लिए नहीं है, क्योंकि हमारा जो एक फोकस है हमारे लिए केंद्र बिंदु क्या है कि भारत के मिडिल क्लास को लोगों ने बहुत सालों से नज़रअंदाज किया है, उनको नकारा है। भारत के मिडिल क्लास को बहुत बार ऐसा लगता है कि एक बार हम वोट दे देते हैं उसके बाद मुझसे कोई बात ही नहीं करता, लेकिन जो टैक्स पेइंग इंडिविजुअल्स हैं जिसके टैक्स पारदर्शिता लाएगी और सबको मैं समझ और देखिए मेन स्ट्रीम में सबको आना है, क्योंकि एक समय लोग राजनीति को देखते थे कि राजनीति में गलत गलत तरह के लोग जाते हैं, जिनके पास परिवार के कोई परिवारवादी हो या जो लोग एक तरीके से समाज में जिनको कोई और बाकी कोई नौकरी नहीं मिला वो लोग रहते हैं राजनीति में, गलत बात था। राजनीति देश का सबसे मैं समझता हूँ कि अहम भूमिका निभाता है, लेकिन इस सिस्टम में अच्छे लोगों को आना बहुत ज़रूरी है। और इसीलिए AIPC में हमने चाहे वो चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट हो, चाहे वो कॉर्पोरेट एग्जीक्यूटिव हो, वकील हो, डॉक्टर हो, शिक्षक हो, जो भी हो, हम चाहते कि वो इसमें आए ताकि इससे यदि वो भविष्य में जाके उनका यदि कोई भी राजनीतिक अभिलाषा हो तो उसको वो पूरा कर सकते हैं। थैंक यू।